हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, बच्चों आज हम क्लास नाइन्थ का जो चैप्टर नंबर फोर है मैथमेटिक्स का, लीनियर इक्वेशंस इन टू वेरिएबल्स, ये बच्चों स्टार्ट करने जा रहे हैं। ठीक है, चैप्टर है हमारा चैप्टर फोर, क्या नाम है? लीनियर इक्वेशंस इन टू वेरिएबल्स। ओके, तो पहले सबसे पहले बच्चों हम मतलब देखेंगे, व्हाट एक्चुअली द लीनियर इक्वेशन इन टू वेरिएबल मींस। ओके, सो लेट अस सपोज एक हमारे पास इक्वेशन है 2x प्लस 3y इज इक्वल टू से 5। ओके, सो देर आर टोटल ऑफ थ्री टर्म्स, वन इन्वॉल्विंग वेरिएबल x, अनदर इन्वॉल्विंग वेरिएबल y, एंड तीसरी क्या है, इक्वल टू क्या आ गए, कॉन्स्टेंट टर्म है हमारी 5। ठीक है, ओके, अब ध्यान देंगे इसको। सबसे पहले तो हमने टू वेरिएबल दिख गए आपको। वेरिएबल इज समथिंग विच कैन टेक अप एनी वैल्यू, जिसकी कुछ भी वैल्यू हो सकती है। अब जैसे यहाँ पे देखिए 5 है, 3 है, 2, इनकी तो फिक्स वैल्यू है ना, जबकि एक्स और वाई दे कैन हैव एनी वैल्यू, दे कैन अज्यूम एनी वैल्यू। ठीक है कि नहीं क्या, तो इसलिए इनको वेरिएबल कहा गया। तो नॉर्मली हम वेरिएबल्स को रिप्रेजेंट करते हैं किससे, हम वेरिएबल्स को जो अल्फाबेट्स होते हैं ना हमारे इंग्लिश के, उससे रिप्रेजेंट करते हैं, स्मॉल लेटर में। ठीक है ना, उसके बाद ये जो चीज़ें ये हमारी कॉन्स्टेंट्स या फिर कोफिशिएंट्स कहलाते हैं। ठीक, अब लीनियर इक्वेशन का मतलब क्या है, ऐसी कोई भी इक्वेशन जिसमें जो वेरिएबल टर्म है उसका जो मैक्सिमम एक्सपोनेंट है, पावर है, वो वन ही हो, इसको हम क्या बोलते हैं, इक्वेशन इन लीनियर इक्वेशन। क्लियर है? तो अगर मान लीजिए जो वेरिएबल है उसकी पावर 2 हो जाएगी तो ये क्या कहलाएगा, ये कहलाएगा क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन, अगर 3 हो जाती है तो क्यूबिक। ठीक है ना, तो पॉलीनोमियल्स वाले चैप्टर में हमने पढ़ा है। ठीक, सो लीनियर इक्वेशन हैज द मैक्सिमम पावर 1 ऑफ द गिवन वेरिएबल। क्लियर है? अब ये तो समझ में आ गया कि लीनियर इक्वेशन है टू वेरिएबल। अब व्हाट इज मेंट बाय सॉल्विंग दिस इक्वेशन, इस इक्वेशन को सॉल्व करने का मतलब क्या होता है? ठीक है कि नहीं, हाउ डू वी सॉल्व इट? तो सॉल्विंग मींस क्या होता है, टू फाइंड आउट द वैल्यूज ऑफ एक्स एंड वाई जो कि इस इक्वेशन को सेटिस्फाई कर सके। सो व्हाट डू मीन बाय सॉल्विंग द लीनियर इक्वेशन इन टू वेरिएबल, इट मींस टू फाइंड आउट द सेट ऑफ वैल्यूज ऑफ एक्स एंड वाई व्हिच व्हेन पुट इन दिस गिवन इक्वेशन विल सेटिस्फाई इट। मतलब एक्स और वाई की वो वैल्यूज पता लगाना जो इस इक्वेशन में रख देने से हमारा इक्वेशन सेटिस्फाई होती हो, लेफ्ट हैंड साइड और आरएचएस क्या आ जाए, बराबर आ जाए। ठीक है, अब इसके लिए बच्चों एक तरीका है, लेट अस सी क्या है वो तरीका। तो इन दोनों में से बच्चों जो दो वेरिएबल्स हैं ना, तो अभी हम देखेंगे हाउ टू सॉल्व इट, हाउ टू सॉल्व इट। ओके, चलिए तो सॉल्व करने का तरीका समझ लेते हैं। ठीक है, इन दोनों में से सेलेक्ट एनी वन वेरिएबल, चाहे तो एक्स सेलेक्ट कर लेना, चाहे कर लेना वाई। नॉर्मली ऐसा वेरिएबल सेलेक्ट करना जिसके साथ या तो कोई कोएफिशिएंट नहीं लिखा हो, और या लिखा हो तो इवन नंबर लिखा हो। समझ में आ गया कि नहीं? तो देखिए यहां तो ऑड नंबर है, ये इवन नंबर है, तो मैं एक्स की वैल्यू निकाल लेता हूं। ठीक है, तो एक्स की वैल्यू कैसे आएगी बताओ, 2x इज इक्वल टू, इसको हम राइट साइड में ट्रांसपोज कर देंगे, 5 माइनस 3y, एंड वी हैव x इज इक्वल टू 5 माइनस 3y बाय 2। सो हियर कम्स द वैल्यू ऑफ x। अब क्या करना है हमको, वी विल गो ऑन पुटिंग डिफरेंट वैल्यूज ऑफ y एंड कॉरस्पॉन्डिंगली फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ x। मतलब क्या बोला मैंने, कि हम y की अलग अलग वैल्यूज को यहां रखते जाएंगे और क्या करेंगे, और हम फिर क्या है, x की जो भी वैल्यू निकल आएगी कॉरस्पॉन्डिंग, वो वैल्यू लिखते जाएंगे, तो हमको क्या सेट्स जोड़े मिल जाएंगे x और y की वैल्यूज के। ठीक है कि नहीं? चलिए, तो अब क्या कर रहा हूं मैं, यहां पे एक छोटे से मैं टेबुलर फॉर्म में बनाऊंगा। ठीक है, एक टेबल बना लेते हैं, तो लेट अस हैव दिस टेबल। तो आपको मैं यहां पे क्या है, 4 या 3 सॉल्यूशन निकाल के दिखाता हूं। चलिए, ऐसा एक टेबुलेटेड फॉर्म बना लेंगे आप, ये सपोज एक्स है, ये सपोज वाई है। ठीक है कि नहीं क्या? ओके जी, एंड सपोज मैं आपको 3 सॉल्यूशंस निकाल के दिखा रहा हूँ, आप जितने चाहे उतने निकाल सकते हो। ठीक है, इसकी कोई सीमा नहीं है, वी कैन फाइंड आउट इनफाइनाइट नंबर ऑफ पेयर्स ऑफ सॉल्यूशंस ऑफ एनी लीनियर इक्वेशन इन टू वेरिएबल्स, बहुत सारे, क्योंकि भाई एक्स की वैल्यू रखते जाएंगे, वाई की वैल्यू रखते जाएंगे और एक्स की वैल्यू निकालते जाएंगे, बहुत सारे आंसर्स पॉसिबल है। ठीक है, तो कोई अगर पूछे कि लीनियर इक्वेशन इन टू वेरिएबल जो होता है उसके कितने सॉल्यूशंस हो सकते हैं, तो वी कैन वर्चुअली हैव इनफाइनाइट नंबर ऑफ सच सॉल्यूशंस। क्लियर? चलिए, सो अभी क्या करना है, y की वैल्यू भरनी है और x हमारा निकलेगा। ओके, सो y की वैल्यू क्या भरनी है, तो नॉर्मली हम ऐसी चीजें सेलेक्ट करेंगे, नॉर्मली छोटे छोटे नंबर्स ले लीजिए, जीरो से ऊपर 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 छोटे मोटे नंबर्स, जीरो से नीचे -1, -2, -3, -4 एंड सो ऑन, इस प्रकार के छोटे मोटे नंबर्स ले सकते हैं। तो एक काम करते हैं, एक तो हम भाई जीरो लेंगे पक्का, एक मैं प्लस की वैल्यू ले लेता हूँ सपोज 2, और एक सपोज मैं ले लेता हूँ माइनस की वैल्यू। ओके, तो मैं तीन वैल्यूज निकाल करके आपको दिखा रहा हूँ। अब इसका सॉल्यूशन कैसे करना है, डायरेक्ट नहीं मारेंगे, ओरली मारेंगे। चलिए, तो सबसे पहला पार्ट हम क्या सॉल्व करेंगे, पुट y इक्वल टू जीरो, पुट y इक्वल टू जीरो, हमको क्या करना है, y इक्वल टू जीरो रखना है इसमें। चलिए, तो x क्या आ जाएगा बताइए, x इज इक्वल टू 5 माइनस 3 टाइम्स 0 बाय 2, एंड व्हाट डू यू हैव, 5 माइनस दिस विल बी 0, तो ये आ जाएगा हमारा कितना, ये आ जाएगा हमारा 5/2, एंड 5/2 इज 2.5, क्लियर। सो वी विल राइट ओवर हियर 2.5, सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट सेट ऑफ सॉल्यूशंस। इफ वी पुट x इज इक्वल टू 2.5 हियर एंड y इक्वल टू 0 हियर, विल गेट LHS and RHS equal. So this is one of the solutions of this given linear equation, two variables. Okay, let us have second one. So what is that? We'll put y equal to 2. So put y is equal to, sorry, 2. Clear? Okay. So now we'll find value of x. So what is x? 5 minus 3 times 2. 5 minus 3 times 2 by 2. Okay. So this one is 3 times 2 is 6. So 5 minus 6 by 2. And this will be minus 1 by 2. And this will be minus 0.5. Is that clear? So here we will write minus 0.5. Okay. Now next one is, we'll have to put y equal to minus 1 in this one. So let us take third one. Put y is equal to minus 1. Clear? Chaliye. Next, we'll find now the value of x. So 5 minus 3 times minus 1. Put it in bracket. Okay? Divide by 2. So minus 3 into minus 1. 2 minuses, they will cancel out and this will make it plus 3. So 5 plus 3 by 2. And this is 8 by 2 and this comes equal to 4. Okay. So here we will write 4. Is it clear? Okay. So now that we have found out three different pairs of solutions of this given equation. So this is how we can find out the solutions of a given linear equation. Okay. Later on, we can plot these points on a graph also. Okay, so how do you plot it on a graph? We'll draw a graph, two lines, one vertical line as y-axis and x-axis. Okay, so here we have the biggest number in positive is 4 and the smallest number is 0.5 on x-axis. So the values of x will be plotted on x-axis. So here we'll write what, biggest value 4, so 1, 2, 3, 4, -1, -2, -3, -4. Okay. Similarly, on y-axis, the biggest value is 2. And in minus, it is minus 1. So, -1, -2, maybe -3, 1, 2, 3. That's enough. Okay. Now, we'll plot these values. First one is, suppose here we'll write 1, 2, 3, 4, -1, -2, and so on. Okay. You can put it over here. So, first point is, the value of x is 2.5 and y coordinate is 0. So y 0 and what is the value corresponding to x? 2.5. So on the x axis you will have to plot it here, 2.5. y 0, x 2.5. okay. And similarly, what is that, x -0.5 and y 2. So we can plot it on a bigger paper. Okay, so I'll show you. Should I rub this? Okay, I'll show it on a bigger scale. So we can plot it so this is how you can plot
graph. This is vertical axis, so y-axis, and this one is horizontal axis, the x-axis, y dash. Okay, this is 0. Now 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4. Enough, I've plotted 4 points. Okay, so 1 2 3 4 minus 1 minus 2 minus 3 minus 4 plus 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 minus 1 minus 2 minus 3 and minus 4. Okay, this is 0. So we have to plot first point. If y coordinate of any point is 0, I've told in chapter number 3, coordinate geometry, if y coordinate is 0 and x coordinate is 2.5, the point does not lie on y axis. If y coordinate is 0, point lies on x axis. So here y coordinate 0, so the point will lie on x axis at plus 2.5. So plus 2.5 will come exactly midway of 2 and 3. So this is our first point, x 2.5 and y 0. Second one is the value corresponding to x coordinate is minus 0.5 and to that of y coordinate is 2. So along the x axis we have to plot 0.5 minus. So this point belongs to corresponds to 0.5 minus. Okay, and second one is y axis 2, positive 2. So this is 0.5 negative and y axis positive 2 is here. So we shift these numbers. Okay, so I'll write those towards other side. 1 2 3 4. Okay, so 0.5 and 2, this is point number 2. Okay, negative 0.5 along y axis, x axis, and 2 along y axis. Okay, last one, the value of x coordinate is 4 and y coordinate is minus 1. X 4 and y minus 1, so this point will be over here. Okay, and we find that all the three points, they will lie in the same straight line. Okay, if we join them using a ruler, we'll find all the three points, they lie on the same straight line. Okay, and since the graph of this equation is a straight line, this is called linear equation. So all the linear equations, when represented graphically, they will give us a straight line, and that's why they are known as linear equations. Clear? So this is how we solve it, and this is how we plot it on a graph paper. Okay, so now we are going to start exercise 4.1. okay, this was just an example of what a linear equation two variable means and how do we solve it and how do we plot its graphical representation. Okay, so this will have to do in exercise number 4.2. okay, so I'm rubbing this. Okay, fine. I hope you understood it. Always plot this on a graph paper and always use your pencil and ruler for this purpose. Okay, fine. So here comes our exercise 4.1. We have only two questions. Okay, so we have been given a situation in question number 1 and we have to formulate it in the form of a linear equation in two variables. Okay, so I'm reading the situation for you. The cost of a notebook is twice the cost of a pen. Okay, I'm putting it in verbal form. Question number 1, the cost of a notebook is, so we can put an equal to in place of is. Okay, so the cost of a notebook is, so what is written is twice the cost of a pen. So twice means two times. Okay, so we have been given the cost of a notebook is equal to 2 times the cost of a pen. Okay, now we have to express this situation in the form of a linear equation involving 2 variables. And what are those 2 variables? So the cost of notebook we do not know. It can be anything. So the first variable will take it as maybe x, and the second one, cost of a pen, will take it as y. So it is already given in the question. Okay, what you have to take as x and what you have to take as y. Okay, so it is given that below this question, it is given in the bracket that take the cost of a notebook to be rupees x. So let cost of a notebook, this is given as rupees x, and cost of a pen, this is given as rupees y. So this is already given. If it is not given, you can take it anything. Okay, so let cost of a notebook is rupees x and cost of a pen is rupees y. So we'll put it in this equation. So according to question, okay, what is the demand? Cost of a notebook, and this cost is what? X. So x is equal to 2 times cost of a pen. And what is the cost of a pen? It is y. So we have the equation x is equal to 2y. And normally the trend is, the normal method is, we always write the terms involving variables x and y towards the left side and constant term towards right side. Okay, so x, this is 2y. Okay, so we will bring 2y towards left. So x minus 2y, and what is left here is 0. So this is our algebraic form. Okay, algebraic form of the given situation. So the answer finishes here. This was the first question of exercise 4.1. You can note it down. Okay, shall we proceed? Okay, fine. Now we'll move on to question number 2. What is that? Okay, express the following linear equations. We will be given some linear equations which will be having variable x, variable y, and there will be a constant term c. Okay, so we have to write all those equations in this format. Okay, and after writing this format, what else we have to do? We have to find out the values of a, b, and c in each case. Also find the values of a, b, and c. These are constants in each case. Is it clear? Okay, fine. So here comes the first one. First one is 2x plus 3y is equal to 9. 2x plus 3y is equal to 9.35, and there is a bar put over 5. So this means only the digit 5 is repeating, 9.355555 and so on. Okay, so let us compare this given equation with the standard form in which we are required to write the equation. This is our standard form. Okay, we have to write the term involving variable x in the first place, thereafter the term involving variable y in the second place, and lastly the constant term. Okay, these 3 must be same. Okay, fine. So let us check it. Here the term involving x is already in the first place, the term involving variable y is already in the second place, but the constant term, it is on the other side of equal to, and we have to bring it to the left side. So we'll bring this one to left side. So what can we do is 2x plus 3y minus 9.35 bar, and they will be equal to left on the right other side. Okay, so now that we have converted it into the required standard form,
Now we will find out the values of these coefficients a, b and c. What is a? A is the constant term along with its sign, which is written with a variable x. Similarly, b is the constant term along with its sign, written with the variable y. And finally, c is whatever is written after that, the constant value along with it, with its corresponding sign. Okay, so what is a? What can you see with x? Along with x, 2 is written, so it is 2. Similarly, what is b? B is 3. And what is c? C is minus 9.35 bar. Is it clear? So this was our part 1. Now second part. There are a total of 8 parts. So second one is x minus y by 5 minus 10. X minus y by 5 minus 10 is equal to 0. If we compare this one with the standard form, we find that it is already in the required form. See, in the first place there is a term involving variable x, in the second place is the term involving variable y, and finally last we have the constant term. So it is already in the required form. So we can straight away write the expression is already in required form. Okay, this is already in required form. So now we only have to find a, b and c. So what is a? What can you see with variable x? There is nothing seen, so we can write 1. If you don't see any number, you can just put 1, because no number written means 1 is written. 1 into x is 1x, that is x. And what can you see with y? So there is no number over here, so we can take it as 1. So minus 1 by 5. So b is minus 1 by 5, and finally c is minus 10. Okay, so this way we've done part number 2. Now we proceed to part number 3. What is that? Minus 2x plus 3y. Minus 2x plus 3y equals to 6. Okay, let us check whether it is in standard form or not. We have a term involving x, we have a term involving y, but the constant term c is on the other side of equal to. So let us bring it towards left side. So minus 2x plus 3y minus 6 is equal to 0. Is it clear? So now it has come in the standard form, required form. So we'll find coefficients a, b and c. Okay, tell me, what do you see with variable x? Minus 2, the number minus 2. With y, it is 3, and finally the last term, it is minus 6. You always have to take care of the sign. If it is written minus, then you always have to write the number with proper sign. Take care of that. Okay, next, part number 4. Okay, this is a good one. X is equal to 3y. Now see this carefully. This constant term c is missing, number one problem. Then the other problem is there is a term involving y, but on the other side of equal to. We have to bring it to the left. So what can we do is bring it over here. X minus 3y equal to 0. Now let us compare it with this one. There is a term involving x, okay, fine. There is a term involving y, okay, fine, in the second place. But where is this term c? We cannot see c, okay. So what can we do is we must write c. So if there is no c, we can just add a 0 in place of c, because if something is not there, we can always say that 0 is there, okay. So if c is not there, that means c is 0. Anything equal to 0 is not present, okay. So we can add 0 in place of c, because it will not make any difference. Okay, so x minus 3y plus 0 equal to 0. So remember, if this one is missing, you will write 0. Okay, if the term involving y is missing, if this is not given, what can you write? You can write 0y, because 0y is 0. Okay, and if the first term involving x is missing, you can write 0x in place of first term. Clear? So you will always have to write all the three terms.
The one which is missing will be written as 0. So this is now in standard form. How can you find A, B and C? What is A? A is, no number is seen over here, so it is 1. What is B? B is minus 3. And what is C? C is 0 because it was missing. So is it clear? This was question number 4. Now let us move on to fifth part. Okay. Should I wrap first and second one? Okay. Fine. So, this is fifth one, okay? And what is that? 2x is equal to minus 5y. 2x is equal to minus 5y. The problem is same as fourth one, okay? The missing term is C, and we'll have to bring this term involving y towards left, okay? By changing the sign. So, 2x plus 5y is equal to 0. And now we have to fit C. So, what can we write in place of C? We can write plus 0. So, it makes it 2x plus 5y plus 0 is equal to 0. Okay. So, this is the standard form. Always put a box on the standard form which is required. Okay. I'm putting it over here. Okay. Now, let us find A, B and C. What is A? A is 2, B is 5 and C is also, C is 0. Sorry. Clear? So we move on to part number 6. Part number 6 is 3x plus 2 is equal to 0. Okay, this one is a different one. Now here we see that the term involving variable y is absent. Okay, so firstly we have to write the term involving x in the first place. It is already in the first place. Okay, so we do not have to change it. Now, secondly, we have to write the term involving y in the second place. And finally, the constant term, okay? So, here we'll insert 0y. So, 3x plus, since y is missing, we can always write it with 0 multiplied by y. This will be 0 and 0 added to anything will make no change, okay? So, this is ax plus by plus c equal to 0. So, finally, we have the equation in the proper form. And we'll now write A, B and C. So what is A? A is 3, B is 0 and C is 2. Is it clear? Okay. So now we move on to question number, part number 7 of question 2. This is y minus 2 is equal to 0. Y minus 2 is equal to 0. So, what is missing here? We are not able to see the term involving x. This one, okay? And this needs to be written in the first place. So, we can write it as 0x. So, we'll first write 0x because x is missing. So, we can put like 0x. So, this will be 0. Plus, secondly, we have to write the term involving y. So, it is here y. And finally C, that is minus 2 equal to 0. So here comes the equation in the proper required form, standard form. Okay, now tell me, what is A? A is 0, B is, there is no number seen over here, so it will be plus 1, that means 1. No need to put plus sign because it is already positive. And C will be minus 2. Hope you are understanding well. Okay, now we come on to last part of this problem, the eighth one. 5 is equal to 2x. 5 equal to 2x. Okay. So, firstly we'll bring 2x to the left side. So, what can we write is minus 2x plus 5 equal to 0. Now, there is a missing term involving variable y. So, after the first term, we will write the variable y with 0 and lastly the third term 5 equal to 0. So, this is the equation in the proper standard form. Okay. So, A is equal to, what do you see with x? Minus 2, B equal to 0 and C equal to 5. Okay. One thing I must point out, listen carefully. It was a problem asked by one of you, I think Prince. In this equation, there are two different possible solutions, A, B and C. The values of A, B and C, it can also be different from these. Okay, so what we can also do is, this is also correct, and what I am telling now, it is also correct. So listen carefully. Okay, I'm asking you something, tell me. If I write x is equal to 3, okay, x is equal to 3, can I write 3 equal to x? It is one and the same. If x is equal to 3, then 3 is equal to x. So we can change sides, both. It doesn't matter, okay, because you may now point out 3, we have brought 3 towards left, so sign must change. Okay, let us find. Sign must change, so we'll write it as minus 3. And we are taking x to other side, it will become minus x, but both minus will cancel out. So it is 3 equal to x. Okay, that means if I write x equal to 3 or I write 3 equal to x, it is one and the same. Okay, it is one and the same. So I am doing 8th one in one more manner. Pay attention. You have to do this one only, just for the sake of understanding. I am telling one more thing. 5 is equal to 2x. Instead of bringing this one to this side, we can take 5 to the other side. It is one and the same. So we will put a 0 over here, 2x minus 5. Okay. Now the term involving y is missing in the second place. So we will write 2x plus 0y minus 5. Okay. Now what we can do is, we can write entire this thing on the left side and 0 on the right side. It is one and the same. Just now I told you x is equal to 3 and 3 equal to x, one and the same. So we can write 2x plus 0y minus 5 is equal to 0. If now we find a, b and c, a will be 2, b will be 0 and c will be. So if we compare this, all the signs are changed. Here a minus 2, here it is plus 2. B 0. 0 doesn't have any sign, so no problem. C minus 5 plus 5. Okay. So if we are getting the values of a, b, c as this one, if we change all the signs, the signs of all the values, it will also be same. So here we can also find a equal to 0, b equal to minus 1, c equal to plus 2. If we change all the signs, it will be one and the same. It does not make any change. Is it clear? So this 8th one can be done this way or this way. Is it clear? So children, this completes our exercise 4.1. Okay, exercise. So we have completed exercise 4.1 and this is your homework. Just complete it in your notebook. In the next video session, we will discuss about exercise 4.2. Okay, I hope you have understood it all. So please make a note of that. And thank you.